Good morning, everybody, and welcome to Chronno Plays Arcade Block. Better late than never, I guess. It is currently the 8th, and I sent that email on the 5th, and I got no reply from tech support, so apparently they're having shipping problems, and tech support is just apparently non-existent. Again, reading the Nerd Block subreddit, apparently that's very common. Apparently their tech support really is just non-existent. Alright, well, that's just something to keep in mind if they start going downhill in these blocks. Alright, let's get to the main attraction and open the box. Oh, all you see is t-shirt on top. Okay, that's unusual. And it looks so far like one of those mashup things. Kind of-ish. Alright, so we can see Deadpool at the top. With a high score and tacos, and that's actually getting kind of annoying, the ooh, random crap. Alright, so let's see, vegetables are fighting Deadpool in a Burger Time thing. Okay, so it's Burger Time and Deadpool mixed up with Nerd Plock. Randomly jammed on the shirt for absolutely no reason. Same with Marvel. Alright, that's actually a little disappointing. I don't mind if you throw your logo on the tag or whatever. I got no problem with that. I have a problem when you just kind of interrupt the shirt for it. But, whatever. It's not terrible. It's not as bad as Loot Crate did with a couple of those. But that's fine. Alright, let's go with that. Then we have, and I read about this by accident, this ought to be entertaining. And I was still not terribly prepared for it. Oh my god, that thing is horrifying. It's Monster Factory version of Mega Man. So it's a warped, distorted Mega Man plushie. That's... What the shit? Okay, that was weird. Random sticky crap. It's now stuck to my hand. Come on, get off my hand. Get off my hand. Get in the... There we go. Alright. So it is, yeah, this Monster Factory plus Mega Man thing. Which I don't get. Always a quick study, Mega Man has an uncanny ability to learn new skills on the run. So, what did he do? He fought these Monster Factory people, absorbed them, and turned into that? I mean, that's just terrifying. Ugh, that's horrifying, actually. Moving along, let's look at this tiny box. It's nesting dolls. Arcade Block nesting dolls, and it looks like Bulbasaur. Bulbasaur, Charizard, Squirtle. Okay, so it's a Pokemon thing, apparently. Possibly all three of them. They're generic nesting dolls, that's fine. Okay. That no longer looks like Pokemon, that looks like Digimon. Okay, that's definitely Pokemon. Come on, give me the other one. There we go. Oh, I get it. Okay. Charmeleon, Charmander, Charizard, Mega Evolution. Okay, there we go. Yeah, I didn't play that version of Pokemon all that much, so I didn't recognize the Mega Evolution that quickly. Voop. And I have no idea what the name is. Or even if there is a name, it might be Mega Evolution Charizard or something like that. All right. Oops. And there I go, shaking the camera. That's what I get for having this giant tripod. I need to get a smaller tripod. Maybe one that's not completely falling apart and being held together by electrical tape at the moment. Moving along. We have something from Resident Evil. Exclusive item, Nemesis figure from Resident Evil. Okay. Now, is this from the Resident Evil movie or just the game? Resident Evil is known for its iconic creatures, and when it comes to the more memorable ones, Nemesis is in the class of its own. Created by the number 6 laboratory in the European office under direct orders from Umbrella headquarters, the goal of Nemesis was to create a new type of BOW. I don't know that word. Apparently it is from the video game that I never actually played. That would carry out orders faithfully and precisely. Its improved intelligence allowed it to make its own decisions and to operate complex weapons. Its main weapon is a rocket launcher. All right. I know very little about the video games. I basically watch the movies. I like the movies. I'm not a fan of horror games. And the video games I wouldn't qualify as horror games. The video games try to be horror games, but they're jump scare horror games. And the movies I wouldn't qualify as horror movies. They would be more action movies. This is actually very well made, from what I can see. I mean, like I said, I don't recognize the character all that well. I don't remember him much from the movie. And this is obviously based on the video game, so that doesn't help. But it looks to be very well made. I mean, it's a very solid-looking figure. I mean, we got Resident Evil 20th Anniversary on the bottom. At least it doesn't slap the NerdBlock logo on it. Exclusively for NerdBlock Inc. That's actually really nice. Huh. That'd be a nice addition to any geek collection. All right, moving along. We have something from Just Cause 3. Grapple Hook Memo Clip. That's going to be interesting, if the picture on the box is anything even remotely like what I see, or what's actually in the box. And it's held together with styrofoam and tape. Just Cause 3 business cards. Okay. It's held together by tape. Hang on, let me get the pocket knife that's older than most of my viewers. It's older than I am. Come on. A little bit more. A little bit more. There we go. Oh. Drop the pocket knife without closing it. That's not a smart thing to do. All right, here we go. We have... This thing's heavy. For its size, this thing's heavy. It's solid, too. Holy crap. All right, the paint job is okay. It's kind of done by a machine. It's got gator clips. This is a weird, weird thing. I mean, it's neat and all of that, and I'm not a terribly big fan of Just Cause. I tried to play Just Cause 2 and could never get the hang of the controls. But... this is definitely an interesting thing. This is weird, man. What the crap? It's a disembodied arm firing off a grappling hook that you can attach business cards to. There, now it's just like on the box. Oop. That is a strange, strange thing. All right. Moving along. We have standard... advertisements for next month. This April. No, not next month. This month, I should say. This April, Arcade Block is bringing you a next level item from Borderlands. Now, is it Borderlands, Borderlands 2, or Stories from the Borderlands? Be specific. Also, this month's Arcade Block contains 3 exclusives. Whoop. Along with some legendary items from Legend of Zelda. Didn't they promise that last month? They seem to promise this a lot. Assassin's Creed and more. Yeah, okay, whatever. Oop, anything else in the box? No, nothing else in the box. Let's take a look at the info and see if there's anything interesting. Marvel Deadpool video game shirt. Okay, anything interesting on it? No. Just Cause 3 grappling hook. Okay, so... never a good thing when your description starts with okay. Okay, so our exclusive Just Cause 3 grappling hook memo holder won't repel you to the highest heights in the gaming world. It's just a memo holder, dude. But it is a pretty cool recreation of what Rico uses in the game, Bonus, it also holds your pictures. It also has his hand, so somebody just kind of went and cut off his hand. And his left hand at that. Pokemon nesting dolls, the exclusive to Arcade Block nesting dolls, are great collectible for our Pokemon fans. Stack 'em or sort 'em, it's completely up to you. After all, a Caterpie may change into a Butterfree, but the heart that beats inside remains the same. Seriously, it's true. So, there's something inside of the Charizard? Or Charmander? Did I miss something? Yes, it's a little Pokemon. It's a little Pokeball with a very, very warped head. So take that into account when you're playing Pokemon. Inside every Pokemon, there is the constant reminder that it is just a slave in a Pokeball. Yeah, there we go. That's depressing. Moving on from that. Whoop. Then we got Mega Man plush toy. Some call him Mega Man, others call him Rock Man. Mega or even Rock. Either way, we're calling this exclusive little guy soft, cute, and lovable. I don't think that qualifies as cute, but okay. Because a Rock Man doesn't always have to be hard, metal, and cold. And then, of course, the feature item, the Resident Evil 3, that answers that question, figure, Nemesis, because Nemesis was in Resident Evil 2. The movie, anyways. Think you could defeat pure evil? Let's hope you never have to find out. In the meantime, you'll have this exclusive Nemesis figure from Resident Evil 3 to keep you company. He's big, he's bad, he's badass. Judging from the description on the box, he's not evil, he's just following orders. He's kind of more of an indifferent. The people ordering him around would qualify as evil, but defeating him wouldn't be defeating evil. That would just be, you know, defeating a minion, I guess. Anyways, all right, so the advertisement goes back in the box, and the traditional everything that I don't want goes back in the box. So let's start with the Pokemon nesting dolls. Honestly, I think these are cute. I like them. It confused the hell out of me seeing this guy, because I've only ever seen Charizard's Mega Evolution once. I've played that game, but I didn't play it all that far, and I didn't keep playing that game. So I only ever saw his Mega Evolution once, and that was it. But I'm going to keep this, because I like it. Then we got the somewhat creepy Just Cause 3 disembodied arm gauntlet thing. Which, it's actually pretty cool. I would use this, and I plan to continue to use it. For what? I don't know yet, but that's staying outside of the box. Then we got the Resident Evil Nemesis statue, which I really like. I do like this statue a lot. So it's staying outside of the box. So far, so good. The shirt. I'm less interested in this shirt than the other shirts, but it's not a bad shirt. I'm okay with it. I will keep it. And then we have creepy ass Rockman here. No. Now, that's just personal preference on this one itself. I'm not going to argue against anybody who likes that thing, but I don't, so that's how it's going to be. So, hey, good show this month, and does that make up for the being, you know, a week late and well over a week after the month that it's supposed to arrive in? No, not really. But again, something to keep in mind when I'm looking at whether I need to keep this or cancel it. So we'll see what happens.